Hi everyone, this is Mix from Sneaks and Ball PH, and today we have a quick look and unboxing on the Air Jordan 5 Alternate Bel Air. To start things off, this Air Jordan 5 is called the Alternate Bel Air because it is an alternate version of the Bel Air Air Jordan 5s that released in 2013. Both the original Bel Air colorway as well as this Alternate Bel Air were made to commemorate Will Smith and the Fresh Prince of Bel Air TV series. The Fresh Prince of Bel Air really was Will Smith's launching pad into, you know, mainstream films and mainstream TV, and is also one of my favorite sitcoms of all time. The Fresh Prince of Bel Air aired from 1990 to 1996, so since it was right smack in the middle of the 90s, you know, the whole theme was very 90s, and these shoes emulate that 90s vibe really well. Then before we get into the shoes, if you are a fan of comedies and you are a Will Smith fan in general, then you should definitely watch the Fresh Prince of Bel Air series, which you can find on Netflix. It's just a very funny and entertaining TV series, so I definitely recommend watching it. Then if you watch the series, you'll definitely understand why Jordan decided to make a special Jordan 5 to commemorate Will Smith and the Fresh Prince of Bel Air. Throughout the series, Will Smith would wear a lot of different Jordans, and the most memorable sneakers that he did rock were definitely the Air Jordan 5s. So it goes without saying that since I am a fan of the show and a fan of Jordan 5s in general, that I'm really excited for this shoe. So with that out of the way, let's get into the unboxing. So the Air Jordan 5 Alternate Bel Air comes in your standard Air Jordan 5 box. So you do have that black oversized lid with a red Jumpman on top. Then you have some cement splatter here on the body of the box. And then here on both sides of the lid, you do have Nike Air branding. And then on this side, you do have your sizing and colorway information. So opening up that oversized lid, and just parting away that black plastic. Ooh, whew. I'm definitely keeping these. So right off the bat, you can see very, very 90s. And if you are familiar with the Fresh Prince of Bel Air, you know that the color scheme is a lot of, you know, neon greens, pinks, light blues, and purples. So you can see those colors all around this shoe. So putting this aside for a while. And then here you have your right shoe, and it's just, this is just such a pretty shoe in my opinion, and you know, I don't know about everyone else, but definitely like these better than the first Bel Airs that released. And it does come with an extra pair of neon green laces, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna put these on because, you know, these do look really loud. Then just getting the other shoe. And here you have it, guys. This is the Air Jordan 5 Alternate Bel Air. Then just a few quick tech specs on the Air Jordan 5. So on the outsole, you do have herringbone here on the forefoot and in the heel, and they do come in translucent rubber. Then you also have some solid rubber with a little bit of texture here on the midfoot and the tip of the toe. Then lastly, here on the forefoot, you do have a few flex grooves. The traction does seem nice and tacky. However, since it is a tacky translucent outsole, there is a possibility that it will attract dust pretty quick. Then of course, the Air Jordan 5s is a 90s shoe, so it's definitely gonna have a durable outsole. Then for the cushion, as with any other Air Jordan 5, you do have a full-length polyurethane midsole with an encapsulated air unit here in the forefoot and a visible air unit here in the heel. Most Jordan 5 retros have this sort of stiffer polyurethane. Jordan Brand did this to the polyurethane so that it doesn't really have that many compression lines and would look a lot cleaner for a longer time. However, that did sacrifice the comfort of the shoe because of course OG polyurethane is not as nice as Phylon, but it was still pretty comfortable. And with these Alternate Bel Air Jordan 5s, I'm happy to say that it seems like they did use a softer polyurethane, so it does feel a touch more comfortable, and you can actually squish the polyurethane midsole with your thumb, which was definitely not the case in some other Jordan 5 retros. So I'm really happy that Jordan Brand decided to soften up the polyurethane a little bit so that we have a little bit more comfort. Then for the upper, you have an almost all leather upper, and can I just say that kudos to Jordan Brand because the leather on this colorway of the Jordan 5s is absolutely buttery soft. The leather that they used on the OG Fire Reds that released earlier this year were really nice as well, but they definitely took it up a notch with these. The leather is just super duper soft. It moves well with your foot, it moves well when you touch it with your fingers, and it's also a pretty substantial cut of leather as well. So right off the bat, if you want a Jordan 5 and you want some of the most premium feeling materials, then you should definitely go with this colorway because the leather on this is just amazing. Then for the other materials, of course, you have that signature mesh here on the lateral and medial side that's covered by this perforated translucent rubbery plastic. Then you also have some of that rubbery plastic here on the bottom half of the tongue. And then for the rest of the tongue, you have this nice and fluffy neoprene. You also have that same neoprene here on the sock liner, and it is just as padded as the tongue. And it just feels really comfortable, like a nice hug around your ankles. Then lastly, you have some plastic here on the shoe with these lace loops, as well as this lace lock. Then for fit and sizing, I did go through the size with the Jordan 5, and it fit me perfectly well. Jordan brand has been pretty consistent with the last few releases of the Air Jordan 5, because the toes on the Jordan 5 do look a lot sleeker, and more like the originals. I really enjoy this sleeker toe box because it fits a lot better, and it also makes the shoe look a little bit sleeker. The tongue as well as the back half of the shoe are also nicely padded, and that of course helps with the overall fit. Then for the aesthetic details of the shoe, you do have those translucent portions of herringbone here on the forefoot as well as the heel. Then underneath the translucent portion of the forefoot, you do have a purple Jumpman. You then have that neon green solid rubber here at the toe as well as the midfoot. And in the midfoot, you have this embossed Jordan text. Then here on the midsole, you do have that visible air unit here in the heel. And then you have a purple polyurethane midsole. Then of course, you have that signature fighter plane design piece here on the lateral side. The left and right shoes are mismatched, so you do have this bluish purple color here on the right shoe with some neon green paint splatter. Then here on the left shoe, it is this really bright pink color with some light blue splatter. Then moving on to the upper, here on the heel you do have a stitched in number 23, and it has that really cool style where you do have the number 23 as well as some shadow. So here on the right shoe, it is this bright pink color with this neon green shadow. Then here on the left shoe, the number 23 is in neon green with a light blue shadow. Then you do have some more mismatched details. So here on the heel of the shoe, you do have this neon green Jumpman with light blue shadow here on the left shoe, and this bright pink Jumpman with neon green shadow here on the right shoe. Then you also have a Jumpman on each tongue. So on the left shoe, it is this neon green, and on the right shoe, it is that bright pink. Then throughout the upper of the shoe, you do have this very nice and clean white leather. Then of course, you have that signature translucent rubber netting here on the lateral and medial side of the midfoot, as well as the base of the tongue. Then aside from those really brightly colored Jumpman logos on the tongue, the rest of the tongue is predominantly black. You also have black on the plastic lace loops and black laces. However, for the laces, just like I showed you a while ago, these do come with neon green laces, so if you feel like you need a little bit more pop of color, then you could definitely swap out the laces. You also have that signature Jordan 5 lace lock that has transparent plastic here on the outside and purple on the lace lock itself. Then here on the sock liner and the back of the tongue, it actually is really wild and really loud because you have all of these crazy patterns and colors that are inspired by the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air TV series. Then here on the back of the tongue, you do have some Air Jordan branding that's mismatched as well, because on the left shoe it is neon green and on the right shoe it is this bright pink. That Air Jordan text is upside down because it's meant to be read when you sort of flip the tongue down, which was sort of a common thing way back in the 90s. Then lastly, you have a white Jumpman here on the insole. Then before I forget, the insole on the Air Jordan 5 Alternate Bel-Air is just your standard ortholite insole, and I would much rather prefer a polyurethane insole because that does stay a little softer, a little longer. But after all, this isn't an OG colorway, so I kind of do understand why they did that. Then for the overall aesthetics, this shoe is just so fire, and this has probably already taken the crown of the best non-OG Jordan 5 colorway in my opinion. This is because the Jordan 5 Alternate Bel-Airs check all of the boxes that I look for in terms of aesthetics. So white leather base, check. Bright pops of color, check. Mismatched look, check. 90s throwback vibes, definitely check. And lastly, visible air, check. So as you can see, this shoe definitely speaks to me, and I'm definitely wearing this the next time I go out. This just really is the perfect Jordan 5 for me, but you know, that is only my opinion, so please sound off in the comment section down below how you feel about the Jordan 5 Alternate Bel-Airs. I also prefer this over the original Bel-Airs because there was just something really off about that gray upper, and I never really grew to liking it. So in my opinion, the original Bel-Airs that released in 2013 are here, and then this new Alternate Bel-Air is just whoop, right at the top. Then for the price, the Air Jordan 5 Alternate Bel-Airs retails for 9,695 pesos or $190. It comes at the standard price of Air Jordan 5 retros and most Air Jordan retros in general. In my opinion, this does feel like it is the most worth it at this price point, and it's not just because of the really awesome aesthetics of the shoe, but this white leather is some of the most premium that you can find on any Jordan shoe. I'm just really still so amazed, like I just keep feeling the leather because it's just really premium, really soft, and the cuts are really thick as well. So if you like getting your money's worth by having really premium materials on your shoe and you love that 90s flavor, then this is definitely the shoe for you. These are still available on the Nike website, so I will leave a link in the description box down below so you can get yourselves a pair if you want one. Most of the common sizes are still available, so that would be like size 8 to 11. But for some reason, the sizes smaller than an 8 and larger than an 11 are already sold out. So there you have it, guys. That was my quick look and unboxing on the Air Jordan 5 Alternate Planet Bel Air. So if you liked the video, please make sure to leave a thumbs up down below. Then if you have any comments, questions, or any suggestions for any future videos, please feel free to leave them in the comment section down below as well. Then also sound off in the comment section down below if you've already watched the Fresh Prince of Bel Air TV series and if you like the show. Then if you haven't already yet, please make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon for notifications. It would help us out a lot. Here at Sneaks and Ball, PH.